Having an exhibition and seeing all of my paintings together has been one of my dreams for more years than I can remember. And I just want to say thank you so much at the start for all travelling here to be here tonight. It really does mean so much to me. Now, there are a few thank yous that I want to say at the start. And the first one is a tremendously big thank you to my family, who have been so amazingly encouraging and supportive throughout this whole process of painting these pictures. And I want to say a special thank you to my parents. When I was only 6 weeks old, they took me to Paris to the Musée d'Orsay to show me the Impressionist paintings.
Oh, 6 weeks?
6 weeks old. So really, they should have seen all this coming. But that said, they have been amazing in terms of giving me encouragement for the past couple of years, always on hand with advice about painting, and Mum in particular actually helped me hang all the paintings this week. I want to say thank you as well to Felix, who's there at the back, for helping me with these lovely wall labels, staying late to work to do it. And kind of my last thank you is a tremendous thank you to the Meditatio Centre for actually giving me this space and this opportunity to hold an exhibition here. And I want to say thank you to Kate, for giving up her Saturday evening to make sure this all runs smoothly. So thank you very much. Now, the journey behind this Cambodia series of paintings really started about 2 years ago. I was going to volunteer in Cambodia for 3 months with a program called International Citizen Service. And in order to do that, I had to raise about £800 of sponsorship. So I'd volunteered abroad before, you know, I'd done the bag packing, I'd done the sponsored walks, and I was looking for something. I was looking for something a little bit different. And I came up with the idea of asking people to sponsor a painting. And the results of people's generosity just amazed me. And many of you here tonight, you hadn't actually even seen a painting at all, and you took a gamble and you took a chance on me, and it was you who kickstarted that whole project. So if it hadn't been for you saying yes at the beginning, I wouldn't be standing here tonight with all these paintings. So thank you very much. So I was really excited about the idea of going out to Cambodia and doing like watercolour studies and drawings while I was there, and then coming back and painting some large-scale canvases. And there we go, this is where it all started. And in fact, if you look at the back where the customs office one is, that was my very first canvas back in October 2014 that I painted. Now, here we go. I was sent along with a team of 7 UK volunteers and 8 Cambodian volunteers to a town in the north of Cambodia called Stung Treng. So very helpfully on this map, it's marked in red, it's right up there in the corner. And actually most of the paintings you see here tonight are from that little town. Now I'm gonna say about Stung Treng, this isn't exactly somewhere you see a great deal of in the guidebooks. Stung Treng is somewhere that people pass through on a minibus. You know, maybe on their way from Vietnam, or maybe on their way to Angkor Wat, to somewhere more exciting. But I really fell in love with this little town. To me, it was a really magical place. And I remember it for its elegant houses on stilts, the surrounding rice paddy fields. And actually my favorite part about Stung Treng was how along the Mekong River that it borders, there are these little cafes that sell fresh coconuts. So you can just go and sit at a cafe by the river and they'll chop the top off a coconut for you and put a little straw in it and you can sit there and drink it, which I thought was fantastic. So while I was in Stung Treng, I lived with a host family, a Cambodian host family. And this was a picture of our house here. And what you can't tell from this picture was actually their house overlooked the river. So for instance, the sunset scene was a sunset that I saw from the balcony where I slept. I slept out on the balcony of this house. And the family ran a Vietnamese restaurant downstairs, just on that ground floor there. So you can imagine the food was just delicious. It was really good. So also in this house, I lived with my Cambodian counterpart, Chenda. So we'd been paired up at the start of the project. And I think as you can tell from the picture, over the course of the project, we just became tremendously good friends. Chenda is just incredibly funny, incredibly wise. I just tremendously valued her kind of support and friendship throughout the project. And Chenda is actually also partially sighted. And she'd been born into a relatively poor rural family. And she'd overcome all of those obstacles to be studying psychology at university. So tremendous inspiration in terms of her strength and her determination. And actually, more than that, she was setting up an online audio library so that all Cambodian students who were blind or partially sighted could have access to key texts that they would need at university. So she is a real, real inspiration to me. My dad is clearly not quite doing his job. I don't know what's going on here. He's not noticing my subtle nods, which is a worry. Now, so I know you haven't heard much about the actual contents of the volunteering yet, so I'm going to just briefly talk about that. So I worked in a smaller team of five people at a little Cambodian charity called My Village. And our main task while we were out there volunteering was to raise awareness about the theme of participation. And that was participation for, I'll just let people get settled.
Sorry.
Oh, no, not at all. Please make yourself welcome, it's fine.
That's all right.
Thank you very much for coming. It's lovely to see you. So. Okay, so I'll just start talking about that bit again. So in terms of work, while I was out there, I worked at a small Cambodian charity called My Village. And I worked there in a small team of five. So there were three UK volunteers and also two Cambodian volunteers in that team. And our task while we were out there was really to raise awareness about the theme of participation. So to encourage more Indigenous people, young people and women to get involved and to have active roles in the village councils. So in order to do that, we ran awareness raising events. So these are actually this one and also the next slide as well. There we go, you got that one, that was all right. These are events that we ran at the local university to really raise awareness about getting involved in the community and what action you could take to make the community a better place. So the work was fairly full on. We worked a completely 9-to-5 week. And on top of that, we were involved in committees as well. And we actually ran other projects like this at, hold on, Dad. We actually ran other projects like this at the weekends. So this was something we did, read